In this session, we are going to solve question number 2 from exercise 3.3. The question number 2, evaluate the following. First example is tan inverse 1 plus cos inverse of 1 upon 2 plus sin inverse of 1 upon 2. Let we consider that tan inverse of 1 is equal to x. It will give tan x is equal to 1, and the principal branch value for tan inverse is open interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. That we know tan of pi by 4 is equal to 1. That tan x is equal to 1 and tan of pi by 4 is equal to 1 implies that tan x is equal to tan of pi by 4, and that pi by 4 belongs to this open interval, that is minus pi by 2 is less than pi by 4 is less than pi by 2, therefore it will give x is equal to pi by 4. That here we re-substitute the value for x, that is tan inverse of 1, therefore here we write tan inverse of 1 is equal to pi by 4. Now we have to calculate here tan inverse 1 plus cos inverse of 1 upon 2 plus sin inverse of 1 upon 2. That we know the property, that is cos inverse of x plus sin inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Therefore that cos inverse of 1 upon 2 plus sin inverse of 1 upon 2, we can substitute directly, the value for it is pi by 2. Therefore we consider that directly, that is tan inverse of 1 plus cos inverse of 1 upon 2 plus sin inverse of 1 upon 2. That is equal to that tan inverse of 1 we calculated, that is pi by 4, and by using property we substitute the value for that cos inverse of 1 upon 2 plus sin inverse of 1 upon 2, that is pi by 2, and for that here we write the property that sin inverse of x plus cos inverse of x is equal to pi by 2, that is equal to, if we take the cross product, here we get 2 pi plus 4 pi divided by 8, that is equal to 6 pi divided by 8, that is equal to 3 pi by 4. Therefore that tan inverse of 1 plus cos inverse of 1 upon 2 plus sin inverse of 1 upon 2 is equal to 3 pi by 4. Now the next example we have, that is cos inverse of 1 upon 2 and sin inverse of 1 upon 2. Here we consider cos inverse of 1 upon 2 is equal to x. It will imply that cos x is equal to 1 upon 2, and the principal branch value, for cos inverse is that the closed interval 0 to pi. And we know that cos of pi by 3 is equal to 1 upon 2. Here we have cos x is equal to 1 upon 2 and cos of pi by 3 is equal to 1 upon 2. Both the right hand sides are equal, implies that their left hand sides are equal. Therefore cos x is equal to cos of pi by 3, and the principal branch value for cos inverse is 0 to pi, and that pi by 3 lies between 0 to pi.
That is 0 is less than or equal to pi by 3 is less than or equal to pi implies that x is equal to pi by 3. Resubstitute the value for x, that is cos inverse of 1 upon 2. Therefore, cos inverse of 1 upon 2 is equal to pi by 3. In the similar way, we calculate the value for sine inverse of 1 upon 2. For that, we consider that sine inverse of 1 upon 2 is equal to y. Implies that sine y is equal to 1 upon 2. The principal branch value for sine inverse is the principal branch value for sine inverse is the closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. And we know sine of pi by 6 is equal to 1 upon 2. Again, both the equations have their left hand sides are equal. We write their right hand sides are equal, therefore we write their left hand sides equal, therefore sine y is equal to sine of pi by 6. The principal branch value for sine inverse is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. That pi by 6 lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Therefore, here we write minus pi by 2 is less than or equal to pi by 6 is less than or equal to pi by 2 gives that y is equal to pi by 6. That is, here we resubstitute the value for y, that sine inverse of 1 upon 2 is equal to pi by 6. We substitute these two values in the required given example, that is that cos inverse of 1 upon 2 is equal to 2 times of sine inverse of plus 2 times of sine inverse of 1 upon 2 is equal to that cos inverse of 1 upon 2 is pi by 3 plus 2 times of sine inverse of 1 upon 2 is pi by 6. Here we cancel that 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6. That is, here we get pi by 3 plus pi by 3. And that is equal to 2 pi by 3. Therefore, we get the answer for cos inverse of 1 upon 2 plus 2 times of sine inverse of 1 upon 2 is equal to 2 pi by 3. The next example is tan inverse of root 3 minus sec inverse of minus 2. Here we consider that tan inverse of root 3 is equal to x. It will give us tan x is equal to root 3. We know that the principal branch value for tan inverse is the principal branch value for tan inverse is open interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. And also we know that tan of pi by 3 is equal to root 3. Therefore, that tan x is equal to root 3 and tan of pi by 3 is equal to root 3 gives tan x is equal to tan of pi by 3. That pi by 3 lies in the principal branch value for tan inverse is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, and pi by 3 lies in this interval, that is minus pi by 2 is less than pi by 3 is less than pi by 2 gives the solution x is equal to pi by 3. That is, here we re-substitute the value for x, that is tan inverse of root 3. Tan inverse of root 3 is equal to pi by 3. Now we calculate the value for sec inverse of minus root 2. For that, we consider sec inverse of minus 2 is equal to y. We know that by property that sec inverse of x is equal to cos inverse of 1 upon x. Therefore, here we write that sec inverse of minus 2 is equal to cos inverse of minus 1 upon 2 is equal to y. We write here reason, that is sec inverse of x is equal to cos inverse of 1 upon x. Therefore, that cos inverse of minus 1 upon 2 is equal to y gives cos y is equal to minus 1 upon 2. We know that cos of pi by 3 is equal to 1 upon 2. Principal branch value, principal branch, principal branch value for cos inverse is closed interval 0 to pi. Okay, that cos of pi by 3 is equal to plus 1 upon 2, and here we have cos y is equal to minus 1 upon 2. Therefore, here we have to use allied angle formula. By allied angle formula, that cos of pi minus theta is equal to minus cos theta. Here we substitute theta is equal to pi by 3. Therefore, cos of pi minus pi by 3 is equal to minus of cos pi by 3. Therefore, cos of, here we take the cross product, that 3 pi minus pi, that is 2 pi by 3. Is equal to minus of that cos pi by 3. We have the value for cos pi by 3 is 1 upon 2. Therefore, both the right hand sides of equation, that cos y is equal to minus 1 upon 2 and cos of 2 pi upon 3 is minus 1 upon 2. Both the equation have right hand sides same. Therefore, we write equality for their left hand sides, that is cos y is equal to cos of 2 pi by 3. And that 2 pi by 3 belongs to this interval, that is 0 is less than or equal to 2 pi by 3 is less than or equal to pi, implies that y is equal to 2 pi by 3. And we re-substitute the value for y, that is cos inverse of minus 1 upon 2 is equal to, therefore, cos inverse of minus 1 upon 2 is equal to 2 pi by 3. And that is sec inverse of minus 2 is equal to 2 pi by 3. Now we substitute these two values in the required equation, that is tan inverse of root 3 minus sec inverse of minus 2 is equal to, that tan inverse of root 3 is pi by 3 minus sec inverse of minus 2 is 2 pi by 3. Here, both the denominators are same. Therefore, we subtract their numerators, that is pi minus 2 pi divided by 3, that is equal to minus of pi by 3. Therefore, we get the solution for given trigonometric equation, that is tan inverse of root 3 minus sec inverse of minus 2 is equal to minus of pi by 3. The next example is, that is cosec inverse of minus root 2 plus cot inverse of, that cosec inverse of minus root 2 plus cot inverse of root 3. That here also we consider that cosec inverse minus root 2 is equal to x. By property that cosec inverse of x is equal to sine inverse of 1 upon x, here we write sine inverse of minus 1 upon root 2 is equal to x. That using the property that cosec inverse of x is sine inverse of 1 upon x, here we write sine inverse of minus 1 upon root 2 is equal to x. The principal branch value that gives sine x is equal to minus 1 upon root 2, and the principal branch value for sine inverse is sine inverse is the closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. And we know sine pi by 4 is equal to 1 upon root 2. Here we have sine x is equal to minus 1 upon root 2. And we know sine of pi by 4 is plus 1 upon root 2. Therefore, here we use the negative angle formula, that is sine of minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. And substitute this theta is equal to pi by 4, that sine of minus pi by 4 is equal to minus sine pi by 4. Therefore, that sine of minus pi by 4 is equal to minus of, that sine of pi by 4 is equal to, that is 1 upon root 2. Therefore, here we substitute that minus 1 upon root 2. Therefore, sine of minus pi by 4 is minus 1 upon root 2. And here we have sine x is equal to minus 1 upon root 2. Therefore, we write sine x is equal to sine of minus pi by 4. That minus pi by 4 belongs to the principal branch value, interval of principal branch value of sine inverse, that is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Therefore, here we write that minus pi by 2 is less than or equal to minus pi by 4 is less than or equal to pi by 2. Therefore, x is equal to minus pi by 4. Here we re-substitute the value of x, that is sine inverse of minus 1 upon root 2, and this is cosec inverse of minus root 2. Therefore, here we write cosec inverse of minus root 2 is equal to minus of pi by 4. Now we consider that cot inverse of root 3 is equal to y. That we know by property that cot inverse of x is tan inverse of 1 upon x. Using this property, we write here, that is tan inverse of 1 upon root 3 is equal to y. That cot inverse of x is tan inverse of 1 upon x. Therefore, that cot inverse of root 3 is equal to tan inverse of 1 upon root 3. And it gives tan y is equal to 1 upon root 3. We know that the principal branch value principal branch value for tan inverse is the open interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. And also we know tan of pi by 6 is equal to 1 upon root 3. That here also tan y is 1 upon root 3 and we have tan of pi by 6 is 1 upon root 3. Therefore we write tan y is equal to tan of pi by 6. Now we have to check only that pi by 6 lies in the principal branch value for tan inverse. Yes, that pi by 6 is greater than minus pi by 2 and less than pi by plus pi by 2. That is minus pi by 2 is less than pi by 6 is less than pi by 2 implies that y is equal to pi by 6. We resubstitute the value for y, that is cot inverse of root 3. Therefore that cot inverse of root 3 is equal to pi by 6. Therefore here we write that is cosec inverse of minus root 2 plus cot inverse of root 3 is equal to, we substitute the values we have calculated, that cosec inverse of minus root 2, that is minus pi by 4, plus that cot inverse of root 3, that is pi by 6. Here we take the cross product, we get minus 6 pi plus 4 pi divided by that 6 4s are 24. Therefore that minus 6 pi plus 4 pi, that is minus 2 pi divided by 24. That 2 12s are 24. Here we get answer is minus pi by 12. Therefore that cosec inverse of minus root 2 plus cot inverse of root 3 is equal to minus pi by 2 is the required answer for given trigonometric equation.